like this type of thing, yeah?
He's hidden
a couple of his good weapons away here, his hands, yeah? Now, the dangers are his head or his knees, yeah? There's other dangers, but those are the classic dangers, right? So, if the guy's here, I'm going to actually get him and bring him there to my side. You know, yes. Everyone expecting that, I've got him. Now, don't strain your neck, right, but try and get your neck back. Yeah? So from here, what I don't want to be doing is he's engaging his elbows, yes?
Yes.
So I'm going to come up nice and straight. And if he tucks his elbows in, which would probably be his next thing, I'm going to bring him around. Yes?
Yes.
Now, why I've got his head here, he shouldn't really be doing nothing with it. Suboccipital nerves, I can tell you what that feels like, yeah? Yeah. And perhaps when I'm covering here, I'm just going to give him a few more in the side of the neck. I wouldn't advise punching his skull, you're going to bust your fist on, yeah? But if I start hitting Fred here, I'll tell you that's a different situation inside of the neck as well. Yeah?
Buzz.
You got that? Sorry, Chris.
Can you control the arms as well?
As you grab,
as he grabs me, I'll perhaps put my head out of the way, I don't want to headbutt. I'll go up with one, because I can reach him. Two, sometimes a problem. Pull a little bit, use the other to assist. Jam him against my chest. Quick one down the centre. Another one, he might start to put his elbows in, spring him around, punch him in there, yeah, uppercut him, yeah?
Yes.